The pi value web part is used to show current values as well as some statistical data like averages. Let's go ahead and add a pi value here. I'll show you how to build one real quick and then we'll look at the details. So I'll go into edit mode on this site. We're currently in runtime mode there. I think I'll put this one in the left column. So we got one in the right, one in the left, and I'll scroll all the way down to where I should find. Yeah, here they are. Here are the pi web parts. I'll choose pi values. And you can't see it, but there's a little add button. I'll go ahead and click on add. It's now added that pi values web part to my left column. There we go. And as of right now, of course, there's nothing to see because we haven't configured anything. So let's go, as we have done before, choose edit, modify shared web part. This is where we can go out and find pi tags to trend. So I'll start with a real simple one, CDT158. This is the one we've used before. You can always do a tag search, of course. And we'll come back and we'll look at some of these other features in just a minute. Now let's just look at what we're going to show by default. By default, we're going to show the name, the time, the value, and the current state, which we'll take a look at that. I'll go ahead and say OK. And we'll exit this mode here, exit edit mode. And here's our CDT158. So a couple of things to point out. The data set is the actual reference, the actual hard reference to the tag. So we're doing that with a combination of server name and tag name. And the nice default behavior of this is when you click on it, it does an ad hoc trend. So there's an ad hoc trend. You can also do the ad hoc trend by choosing from here and choosing ad hoc trend. So there's a couple ways to do that. Now, let's look at this thing called the current state. If you recall, when we configured this, it was simply labeled, I believe we labeled it state, or current state. Now, it shows in a bar graph the current value extending up and down from the typical value configured for that tag. Each pi point has an optional typical value, or I shouldn't say optional, sometimes people just leave it at the zero, but there's a typical value that can be configured. So what we're doing is showing you the 0 and the 0 plus the span as the endpoints of this bar graph, and then we show the value extending up and down from the typical value. So the idea is if it typically should be running at around, 100, we can see at a glance how close it is to that typical value. Now, there's some other things on here that we didn't show at this point. We didn't show the descriptor, the engineering units, etc., but all of these things are available. Okay, all the things you see listed here. And as before, what I would suggest you do is, if you're really interested in what all of these things do, the obscure ones that are not obvious, like start of interval, etc., if you're interested in that, take a look in the documentation. You'll find much more in detail information there. And also, we do in our regular RT web parts, a computer-based training, we describe this in nauseating detail, so every single item here. So, but let's just take a look at some of the key ones. One of the key ones is that you can do something like this. You can add an average to this, in which case, what we're going to do is do an average based on the values that are stored here in the summary parameters. Now, the summary parameters are basically the key for what that average is going to be. So for example, if my calculation interval is 1 day, then that's what that average is going to show me, a 1 day calculation interval. Now the sync time is what we're using to specify the time at which that 1 day starts and stops. So in this case, the sync time at midnight indicates that with an average, what we're going to show is the average as of midnight, a 1 day average as of midnight. And there's three ways we can show this. We can show this as a moving average, as a fixed average, which simply means we're going to show the last available value for whatever the current timestamp is. We'll show the running average, which means if we are currently midway through the 24-hour period, we'll go ahead and show you what the current value is. Or we can do moving, in which case we're actually going to be doing this displaying this as a moving average extending back from the current time. Now one of the things you can do, and I suggest you do this with when you're showing these kinds of aggregations, these averages, is to display the summary settings. So for example, if I set this at fixed, I display the summary settings, it's going to show me on this web part exactly what timestamps are associated with that average. So we can see here, today it's the 14th, so the summary settings are showing me it is from the 13th at 12 to the 14th at 12. That's what we're showing as this average. Here's the average right here, 153.46. Now compare that average to what you would see as for a start time and end time of that average if you had chosen moving instead of fixed for the summary settings. So let me go in here. I'm choosing, instead of fixed, I'm choosing the moving average. And with a moving average, what you're going to see is a 24-hour average, but it's an average ending right now. So since I chose to show those summary settings, you know, that it's a lot more information, better information than just showing people this without explanation as to what that average is. Well, as I said, we're not going to cover everything in this particular class. One of the more powerful features, very, very powerful feature, is these behavior settings. Behavior settings allow you to predefine kind of templates for how you want all your data to show up. So, for example, watch what happens if I just switch this over to solution values config. If you notice, everything about this changed. Notice when I choose none, we basically start with a blank slate, and you can go ahead and put on here anything that you want. Now, if you decided you want to show more than one at a time, you have control over how much of that value or those values you actually show at one given point in time. So let me go back in here and specify more than one tag. Let me change my behavior settings back to the default. Yeah, that's the default set of settings. I've removed my average, and that's okay. But what I'd like to do now is go out and find more tags. So let's find all the tags that begin with the letters BA. And I'll put an assortment on here, concentration level. Let's see. We'll go with temperature. I'll add those. We will also take the tags that all begin with the letters CD. We've already got a couple of those. Let's add these. So with these tags, it's more than the default number of rows. The default number of rows is 5. So what's going to happen with this is we're going to show the first 5 and then allow you to scroll through the rest. Yeah, we can see here's the first 5. I'll go ahead and click on this and I can see the next 5. In this case, just 2. But that is an option that you can control through the configuration. So you can change that if you want to see all 7 of these at once. Just go down here and change your default number of rows. Just make that a suitably large number and acknowledge. There we go. We're seeing all 7 at once now.